Hi, I'm Kate. I'm the Talent Specialist for HCD here at Aquin Australia, and I'm coming to you today from beautiful Yagul country in Yamba in northern New South Wales. I wanted to share with you today a checklist I've created to help people pivot into job search mode on LinkedIn. We're seeing a lot of uncertainty in the market today, quite a few roles impacted by redundancies and restructures and project scale backs, and I just wanted to help in supporting in any way I can. So let's get started. Step one, update your LinkedIn essentials. This is your contact details, your web links, and your headline, because this is searchable to help people find you. Step two is to update both of your open to work statuses. So this is the frame on your profile picture, the green frame. It's also the open to work preferences. And a top tip, by setting your open to work status as well, this elevates your profile and it makes you as a like an active profile on LinkedIn. So it boosts you up in search results. It's a good thing to do. Step three is to let your network know. You want them to help boost your messaging, increase your visibility. If you're part of a larger restructure and there's a hashtag, you know, add it in there. Anything that can help your profile and your update be visible is certainly going to help in terms of extending that reach. Step four is to optimize your LinkedIn profile. So starting your about section with a statement that clearly states what you're looking for and then lead on to your career story. Ensure that each of your work placements have content in there. They've got details about, you know, what you did, who they are, the organization, and ask for recommendations from your network, from your colleagues, and be sure to add these to your LinkedIn profile. Step five is to update your supporting documents. I recommend starting with your work samples, so your case studies, project overviews, your portfolio or your website, because you can use your LinkedIn profile as an interim resume or CV. Obviously, you do want to then create an updated resume or CV as well. Step six is to connect for support and start your proactive search. So if your work, particularly if it's part of a larger scale restructure, is offering support services, be sure to connect for these and engage with them. The other thing I'd recommend is to reach out to recruiters that specialize in your area that are working within your space, such as myself. The other thing you can do is really kickstart on LinkedIn with things like following hashtags, following organizations, and then keep an eye on your profile feed as it rolls through, because you might find job opportunities pop up there. You can also do some saved searches for job postings as well. So allowing things to come to you rather than you having to continually search for them. Step seven is to establish a system to keep yourself organized. I recommend creating some message templates that you can use for quick replies. Also, create some type of a system that can track your calls, your meetings, your Zooms. You also want to keep track of which clients or organizations you're engaging with and any roles that you've applied for. I hope this has helped, particularly if you are impacted by restructure or your role has been affected by redundancy. If you know someone that has and might benefit from this, please feel free to share it along. And as I said, I'm going to link below in the comments to the full blog post for all the details.